I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, you're going to see how you can use the Parade Scopes to help you identify what steps you need to take to make two shots match one another better. So the first thing I'm going to do is right-click the viewer and show the scopes, and I have the scopes set to display the Parade Scope. Looking at this first clip, I can see that the bottoms of the three waveforms are fairly well balanced. The tops of the waveforms are just a little imbalanced with weaker red and stronger blue. If I click on the second shot, now I can see there are quite a few differences happening here. First off, whereas the bottoms are somewhat aligned in the first shot, they're not nearly as well aligned here. Now, up in the highlights, I can see that there's a bigger discrepancy in my upper midtones. Specifically, if I look in my midtones here, I can see that those are pretty out of whack. So first off, I'm going to start by trying to get some of the blue out of the shadows. Now, I happen to know that this first node is my primary grade, and I'm going to use the lift control. And adjusting the lift control, I'm trying to make the bottoms of these three waveforms line up a little better. And in doing that, if I flip back and forth, I can see that the bottoms of the waveforms are resting right at absolute zero here. So I'm going to want to drag my lift master control down to rest the very bottoms of these graphs similarly right at absolute zero. So there's my first adjustment. I can really notice that his coat is lighter in the second image than it is in the first. Now, I could try to use my gamma control to throw more of the image down, and that helps, but only to a degree. At this point, I'm probably going to want to use my curve. So by just using this bottommost point, I can squeeze the shadows intersecting the coat down so that I get a much nicer match, but I don't lose any of the lightness around his face or in the rest of the scene. Now, I'm probably going to want to add a couple more points to kind of round this adjustment off a little bit. So that takes care of my midtones, although I still have a blue problem. Now, the highlights don't look that off. If I look at the whites, the brightest whites actually look fairly white, fairly neutral. They don't look bright blue. So I'm thinking that that's not my worst problem. I'm thinking that my biggest imbalance is in the midtones, which I can see by virtue of the red midtones being very low and the blue midtones being very high. So I'm going to try turning to the gamma control, and I'm going to try and fix that by pushing gamma up a little bit towards the complementary of blue, which is orange yellowish. Now, I don't want to overdo it because then I turn everything orange and warm, and that's not the point. But at this point, I think one of the things that's happened to me, I had to increase the contrast to the point where saturation got boosted. So I'm going to desaturate this image just to the point where I get equivalent color in the face of the man in both of these shots. So I feel like that's pretty good. And at this point, I can actually ease off that color balance adjustment just a little bit. And right here, I think I'm pretty close. If I play through these shots, at this point, it's fairly convincing that they're both in the same place at the same time. Now, I can keep futzing with this, but this is a good place to leave off. Again, I hope this has been useful for you. If you want more information on how to grade using DaVinci Resolve, I strongly recommend you check out my grading in DaVinci Resolve 11 title, available from Ripple Training. Thanks so much for watching.